It is a packed house out here on the jetties this morning, folks. There are tons of boats. And, yep, we're on. There's a fish. We're on. There's a good one. There's a good one. What's happening, folks? Welcome to another video. It is spring break here along the Florida Gulf Coast, and I've been getting so many messages from you guys that are like, hey Brant, we're coming down for spring break. Where can we catch fish? What can we do? And so we're gonna go on a little adventure today and just kind of show you guys some stuff that you can do in order to be successful when you're down here. Now check out, it is beautiful out here this morning. We are at the pass. And even though it is spring break, it doesn't feel like spring break. It's in the low 40s this morning. So I don't know if that's going to do anything to the fishing or not. We do have two rods rigged up and ready. We've got some bait in there. This time of year, hanging around these passes is probably going to be your best bet to be successful. That's where a lot of these fish hold up. Ah, big one. We're going to first start at the end of the jetties out here. Just because traditionally, now I haven't fished the jetties in 2 years, but traditionally it's a good spot. You warm up real quick making this walk. I ain't even cold anymore. Here's where the fun really begins. We have got to get on these jetties right here and go out another 100 yards. Getting out here is not easy. You got about a mile walk, then you get here and you gotta go walk all these rocks. This is where it gets difficult and dangerous at the same time. It is a packed house out here on the jetties this morning, folks. There are tons of boats. I'm going to take a little live shrimp, hook it on a Carolina rig, and see if we can get bit. I'm gonna walk right down here, see if we can get bit. There is a lot of folks here. All right, I guess right here will be all right. It gets super slippery out here, so if you are going to fish here, be careful. I'm just telling you. We don't have the greatest tide today. It's not very good at all. I think there's gonna be enough fish around that we'll still be able to get some bites, even with a bad tide. It is a neap tide. A neap tide is not a great situation, especially around jetties. And these are all your charter boat captains right here. It does look like they're catching a few fish. These fish seem to be a little further out. So it's gonna be a lot better if you got a boat. Oop, oop, there's a little bite right there. I don't know if he's on. Oh yeah, oh yeah, come on. Dang it, that was definitely a bite, but I don't know if we... Yep, we're on. There's a fish, we're on. There's a good one, there's a good one. First bait in the water today, y'all. First bait in the water, right here. There we go. Oh my, he broke me off on a rock. You gotta be kidding me. No, the hook just pulled. He ain't even break me off. We just had a pulled hook. Golly. All right. That's a good sign. Let's get another bait out there. Good gracious. Man, that would have been a great start. First bait in the water. And we were on with a solid fish. And he just came unbuttoned. I'm guessing it was a sheep's head. Sometimes pretty hard to get a good hook set in. There we go. There's a fish. Oh, that's a good one there. That's a good one there. That's a good fish there. Thank you. Come on, buddy. Get on up here. First fish off the jetties this morning, folks. That's a nice sheep's head. Check that one out. We're gonna keep this guy. That's a fatty. Let's get another shrimp going here. That was a good first fish to catch. If you are booking a charter right now in this area, and it's an inshore charter, there's a really good chance they're gonna take you here because the bite has been pretty good. I'm just sitting down chilling. Hopefully we'll get a bite soon. You know what's really good about it right now is there's not a lot of trash fish here. And so we're able to keep our baits in the water a while. There's not a lot of pinfish and different stuff like that. So that's a positive thing. I think I'm getting a bite. Yep, that's a good one. That's a good one. That's a good one. We got another one. He's in the rocks. Swim out, dude. Swim out. He's in the rocks. Golly. There we go. He's out. He's out. Come here. Oh, that's a, I'll flip him. That's an easy flipper right there. There's number two. Nice fish right there. Another shrimp going right here. Having a little action out here on the jetties this morning. Ugh. I'm gonna sit back down. Seems every time I'm sitting down right now, I'm getting a bite. So you know why you get bites when you're sitting down and you're not that serious about it? It's because you don't care as much. And when you don't care as much, you magnetize those fish to you. That's a little fishing secret. Oh, there's the bite. Come on. There we go. Follow for more wisdom. Oh, and he came off. All right, you can unsubscribe now. So that one actually cut me off on the rocks right when I was talking all kind of smack too. So, but you gotta admit, we got the bite. We did get bit. Which that's the name of the game. We just didn't get him in the boat. Or on the jetty. All right, I'm gonna sit down again. We're just gonna let them fish come to us. All right, we're gonna get bit. Nobody's catching anything right now. It's kind of died. I haven't even seen the boats catch anything lately. I'm getting bit right now, I believe. I don't know if he's on there or not, but. Yep, we got him. There's a fish, got him. Sitting down always works. Sitting down always works. This is, feels like a smaller one, I think. Well, I don't know, dude. That's a good one. We're about to take these guys home and cook them up. How you doing? Yeah, they're biting pretty good out at the end. We have almost made it off the jetties. Thank goodness. My Lord. It has been a walk. Hello. Yep. Pretty good bite out there. What's that? Oh yeah, we did. I caught some nice ones. Okay. Yeah, there's quite a few fish being caught out there.
Yeah.
We got some nice ones out there today, and they're really biting, starting to bite good. We could have stayed out there for a while, but hey, I'm ready. I got all I need. I needed to catch lunch. We accomplished that goal. Fred, I haven't seen you all year. It's good to be, now you're scared of me. Scared of me. Another thing that's cool about this area right here is if you don't want to make the crazy walk out there to the jetties, you can fish the seawall. And I have a lot of videos fishing this seawall and being really successful. So don't think, and it's only about a 50 yard walk. So don't think you have to go to the end of the jetties.
That was a fun morning. And you know, that was the first normal fishing trip I have made maybe this year. I've been doing a lot of like adventure and travel type stuff. We did keep a couple of these sheep's head right here for dinner, and those are some healthy ones. And I really just wanted to show you guys that it is spring break, and I know a lot of you guys are traveling down here. And if you are, I'm gonna go around the rib cage on this guy just because I want to do it kind of quick. If you are traveling down here for spring break and you just want to catch some fish, those jetties are a really solid spot right now. That's why there was so many charter boats out there. If you decide to go to the jetties, you're going to have a little patience. All right. First of all, the walk out there is pretty tough. You're going to get hung up. You're going to break off, and you're probably going to get hung up with other people with some of those boats. So if you have some patience and want to get out there in that, you will catch fish right now just because there's a lot of fish out there. And look at this guy right here. That is he's got a lot of meat on him. That's a pretty big one. That's a pretty healthy fish. I like to when I'm just cleaning them quick like this and by myself, to go around the rib cage like I did right there, just to kind of save the knife. If I had a serrated edge blade knife with me, I would cut through it, but I don't have it with me. These sheep's head can be tough to clean. Everything's big on them. They have big scales, super short. Look at these fins right here. Those fins, you don't know how many times when I was running fishing charters that those fins, I've had them drop in my toes. I've had a whole fish drop, my client dropped a fish one day and that fin went right into the top of my big toe. I've had so many incidences with those fins. There we go. We're gonna get we got some nice fillets off that one side. We're going to clean the rest of this guy. This time of year is one of the only times of year that we consistently catch those sheep's head like that. And that is why you're seeing sheep's head videos. I made a sheep's head video several videos back where we fried them up out here and they were pretty good. We're going to cook these in the house. So today with this fish, we're going to do a very simple seasoned fish recipe. Sheep's head is a very flavorful fish, and so you don't have to do a lot to it. We're going to season it up with some Tony's, coat it with some seasoned flour, and then pan fry this guy. But you know what? I thought while I'm cooking this fish up that this would be a perfect opportunity, since it is spring break, to just chat with you about some things that we have going on. You know, we have such a large out-of-town audience that views my channel, and I know that a lot of you guys come down here to vacation either during spring break or in the summertime. I don't want you to miss out on what we have to offer. So first of all, we do have an outdoor store called Beach Bum Outdoors. If you're new to the channel and you haven't been following along, it's in Gulf Shores, Alabama. We sell all kinds of fish and tackle, live bait, frozen bait. You can come and get fully stocked up to go do what you see me do on this channel. And also, and I have worked with so many of my subscribers over the years since 2018 on buying and selling real estate along the Gulf Coast. I am a licensed real estate agent, and that is what I do. And you know, the way I've built this business is through sharing a common ground with my viewers, because we're both into fishing, and then they contact me because we have that common ground with each other, and I end up doing real estate deals with them. So if you ever have any interest in buying or selling property here along the Florida Gulf Coast, then, or Alabama Gulf Coast, I'm not licensed right now in Alabama, but I will be soon, but we have people on our team that are licensed there, so if you need help in Alabama, we can help you out there too. Please don't hesitate to hit me up. All my information is linked in the description below. So we're gonna get this fish pan fried in butter and olive oil. Here is the final product here, folks. We've got our fresh sheep's head. We've got some rice. We've got a dipping sauce. This is Primal Kitchen cilantro lime mixed with mayonnaise. First of all, I'm gonna try the sheep's head with no dipping sauce. Straight from the Gulf to the table. It does not get any fresher than that. I'm gonna try a little bit of this dipping sauce. That is super flavorful. You should try this on fish. I'm dead serious. That is one of the most flavorful sauces that I have had on fish. So it's really, really good. Folks, if you enjoy that video, please shoot me a big thumbs up. All the videos I'm making on this channel, I'm trying to mix up. I'm trying to bring you new and fresh content every single week. And so if you have any ideas or anything that you want me to do, or if you're catching anything now that you think would make a good video and want me to come fish with you, shoot me a message, comment below. I do read all the comments and I try my best to respond, even though I know that I don't get to all of them, and I apologize for that. But, and also, like I said earlier, everything else we're involved with is linked in the description below. We'll catch you next time.